I've been asked to talk a little bit about our missions in Grace Communion International, and I'm involved mainly with the Crossing Borders mission. We started back in 2006. Our intent was that we would take youth who had been to our youth camps for a number of years and be able to take them kind of to a different level and give them some experiences that they couldn't have maybe back at the youth camp, and just widen their horizons a little bit, add some maturity to their spiritual growth in a different way. And then when they went back to their youth camps as a counselor or activity director, they'd have this added level of education, spiritual education that they had gotten. So that's where we started with it. And so now we're 7 years down the road, 7.5 years down the road. We've taken, this will be our 15th trip into Mexico this year. We go twice a year, for a week in the summer. We go for a weekend in the winter and deliver shoebox Christmas gifts to the kids that we've got to know in the summer. We go back to reconnect with them in the winter. You go into another country, there's always questions about, is it safe? You know, if I go there, wherever that there may be, it's going to be different than living in your neighborhood and a town you're familiar with. So we work with these ministry partners to try to keep it, you know, as safe as we can, to know where to go, where not to go, what to do, what will be helpful to them. We went out to what they call a colonia, which is kind of like a real poor neighborhood. And when we got there, they were just excited to see us, and they were very welcoming and excited. It was mostly a bunch of mothers and young kids, because we were going to do a vacation Bible school. And we got out all our supplies, and there were a few folding tables, and we brought some chairs, and we began to do a Bible study again for another couple of hours out in the hot sun, singing and dancing to music and doing their Bible lessons. Toward the end, we had brought some puppets. We're going to do a little puppet skit show about the gospel at the end. And we took our folding tables that the kids have been using for vacation Bible school. We set them up over in front of the puppet stand. And those little kids come run and dive underneath the tables because that's the only shade that they could find. Some people wonder why they should be interested in going on a short-term mission trip. You wonder, can we do any good in a few days or a week in the lives of the people that we're going to touch? And the thing is, yeah, you can do an awesome bit of difference in just a short period of time, even if it's just a few days. So I'd recommend anybody to get a chance, you know, go on some sort of short-term trip. Just the encouragement you bring to the people, much less the teaching, much less the gospel message that they may or may not have ever heard before, put in a way that's relatable, you hope, through your activities, through playing with them on the playground and eating meals with them and doing lessons and just talking to them and being there with them. Those relationships make a big difference in the life. It transforms not only the people that you're going to see, but everybody we've taken on the trip has come back different, because it broadens your scope of what's going on out there in the world. You see a lot of love that you not only give, but that comes back to you from the people that you're helping. And we've always come back from the mission trip, it seemed like, much fuller than we went, even though we went to give, and we tried to do that. We came back feeling like we had been blessed so much by the people that we got to see. They're all God's kids. And when you go visit with them and share with them, it's just part of the family. So it really broadens your view of what God's got going on in the world. There's many other people that are doing mission work too now in our denomination. Grace Missions is one. Great Commission Trips is one. We got one down in Jamaica. We call it Jamaica Jam. We got a brand new one called the M2540. Mission trip, and that goes over to Africa. We've got Word in the Street, which is a domestic mission, which goes to some inner city areas here in the U.S. And our mission trips are open, most of them, to not only youth, but on into the adult years. Ours says age 15 to 99, so if you fit in that category, you know, come on down. And that's what most of them will do, is take adults too, because we need our view widened of the world as well as our kids. Another benefit, I think, of the mission program is that our youth camps get benefited from it. Because if the youth camps have growing leaders that are moving up through their ranks, and those leaders, say, take a mission trip somewhere during that period of time, their mind gets expanded, and their spiritual maturity is increased, I think, in some ways. It also helps the local church, because these people come back from these mission trips, again, with their views expanded, and they can bring that back to the local church and help give some more sense of mission and vision even to the local church. And it gives the local church an outlet to sponsor these people. And to everybody in the local church may not be able to go on the mission trip, but if someone goes on the mission trip from that church and comes back and tells those people what they helped participate in through their financial giving and their prayers, or maybe by sending handmade gifts and things with them on the trip, you can involve a whole local church in a mission trip, even if the whole church can't go on the mission trip. And I think that really gives people a new vigor and excitement.